this forums video in which I am going to just go through things that interest me in this skyscraper page forum. Been kind of on this forum for several years, not really more of a lurker, less of a poster, but I don't know, I just find following developments in a city very interesting, and I figure why not capture it. Also, Braden requested this, so shout out to Braden. There's a window washer outside my window. So that's a bit distracting. I got some pineapple flavored sparkling water here. And let's go. Okay, so the first thing that I thought was interesting that I wanted to look at was these city compilations. Super tall looks interesting. But this is the global section. I don't really want to be in the global section. I like regional stuff. Canada, Alberta, and BC. For sure, I want that. That's my area. I'm interested in Toronto. I'm interested in Vancouver. Was good too. And you know what? Asia Pacific, Australia, and Hong Kong. Alright. So I got a bunch of tabs here. And I'm going to be subscribing to different threads as well. So, looks like there's some sticky threads. Alberta highway construction. Okay, well, Vancouver, I guess. I already have Vancouver here, so we can get rid of that tab. Trying to stay organized here. Okay. Downtown Vancouver updates. I don't know what this is, but it looks. Seymour Street's turning into a bit of a canyon lately. Downtown Eastside issues, we don't really have to go there right now. Road infrastructure, the exchange. There's some new stuff going on there. That's one of my favorite buildings in Vancouver. Metro Vancouver and the Fraser Valley. Suburban updates. Surrey, South Fraser. Georgetown, Wally Station. I heard Wally Station actually just got approved by City Council, so that's interesting. Quayside. Amazing Brentwood, that's a really good development. Polaris, not sure what that is. Surrey City Center redevelopment plans. Westminster Pier. There was actually, I'm going to do a quick Google search and show you, I think we're going to be using Google Maps today because my I'm only recording Mozilla Firefox, so So this here was an art piece. Well, art, I don't know if it's art, but it's a couple container, four containers in the shape of a W on a pier held together by cables. And that was standing for years on a wooden dock that was located right here. Right there. But this entire dock burned last year. And it's gone. And I'm pretty sure that the W fell into the water. So that's gone. It's quite sad that it's gone, but it's gone. And I don't remember why I brought that up, but I did bring it up. Okay, I think we have a lot on our plate here, so let's just get into it. Station. Okay, this is the this is the one that just got approved. Let's go to page one. Also, thread tools, subscribe, add it to my list. Okay, so this is what it looks like right here, or what it will look like. This street corner is a historic step. that here? Hard to tell, to be honest with you. See, there, they've got all of these plans here. They started with this, then they did this, then they're doing this, and then they're gonna probably finish it off with that, but they're gonna anchor it with that. 182 meters. Yeah, it's quite tall for Surrey, I would say. It got approved by council on April 13th. For context, this tower will be the same height as Brentwood 3. So Brentwood 3, I think, is this here to the amazing Brentwood Towers 1 and 2. I don't know where 3 is, actually. Those are the Brentwood Towers. What's going on here? Okay. I'm gonna subscribe to this thread as well. So just to give you an idea. This is Metro Vancouver. Brentwood is up here. Right here. One, two, three towers. There's a station here, Metro Station, and there's kind of a theme in Metro Vancouver and a lot of Canadian cities where they're trying to control the growth. Trying to build transit-oriented development where they put towers near stations to incentivize people to use the stations. And a lot of the malls have been dwindling in their relevance due to e-commerce, etc. And so what they're trying to do is they're trying to anchor their retail presence by building residential high-rises on the same lot as the mall itself, which will secure future customers to the mall, if that makes any sense. So, like, it'll be so convenient for these residents to shop at the mall that it pretty much guarantees that the mall will have customers, which I think is a smart idea. I think down here in Metro Town, they're doing the same. They're going to do a similar thing. And this mall here is also going to be doing that. I know they're planning towers here, and all over here. This is all their property. So, yeah. But anyway, so this is where the Wally one is going to be, right here. On this street corner where this parking lot is. And there's the station right there. So this area is considered like downtown Surrey. Surrey is just a suburb right now, at least for now, because Vancouver's way over there. Well, I think Vancouver will always be top dog in the region, to be honest. Anyway, yeah, I think we've milked this one. This is a weird one because it's literally in the water, almost like if we go to back to the Google Maps, it's like right here, right on this parking lot, I think. nice, and I like the public space. That's kind of cool. I didn't think it was going to be public. I thought they were going to make it all private space. There it is. See that? Right there. Very nice. Looks like it's gonna be taller than the sky bridge. That bridge is for SkyTrain. It's not a road bridge. Fantastic. Change the urban fabric. Unfortunate that it went from 1,000 units down to 660. Yeah. Yeah. I agree with this guy. This is back in 2017. Seems like it would be the most at risk during foundation construction while there's nothing in the inward site or during a big earthquake. Say it's amazing. Can't wait to watch the construction progress. It's been over 3 years since my buyer purchased a high floor unit in Pier West. It'll be another 4 years until occupancy, so 7 years minimum. Huge life changes can happen during this time, so us realtors are now making provisions for that. Yeah, we have a huge housing shortage in Vancouver. Wow. Okay, I believe I subscribed to the thread. Yeah, I did. Okay, let's just move on. These are the Brentwood Towers. There's the station. There's downtown Vancouver with the mountains. There's a bit of a video. I'm not going to play it because I don't know if it's going to be loud. I don't think it will, but I'm just going to leave it. Yeah, so Vancouver has view cones. They don't allow you to develop within certain view corridors, and so none of the towers in downtown Vancouver are exceptionally tall. So this guy is saying he hopes that the other cities start building higher, which I agree with. That would be great. I think Vancouver can keep its picturesque views and then just allow the suburbs to overshadow the downtown, and then you're gonna get it. I think it's just gonna produce a very interesting range of experiences, like urban experiences in the region. SFU building. I think this is Cortland Park here, and this is 104 Avenue. City Hall is right there. That's the hub I was talking about over there with the Coast Capital building. What is this? City Center. Okay. Anyway, So sad. That is so sad. I'm not gonna go to the live feed, actually. So yeah, it's just all gone. See, this is the improved half. This is the unimproved part. At least it was the unimproved part. There was just some stuff and whatnot, but very sad. Okay, that's the Seattle stuff, so I'm just going to subscribe to this thread and I'm going to close that tab. Okay, pics by me. So this is the so. amount of smooth finish tile I've seen used in the lobbies and even building exteriors around town is absurd. If it's through your nose, it's a wet and often non-slip because any top coat solution will look. Yeah. I'm not a big fan of that design either, to be honest. It's expensive.